Okay, this is another whispered ASMR story in Mexico. I specify that because you're going to hear sounds outside that maybe you're not used to. Yeah, sometimes people drive by playing mariachi music. It's too late at night for the vendors to be coming by, so there won't be any shouting. But yeah, I'm relatively lucky, like my neighborhood is so quiet. Can you hear the crickets? Maybe if you listen carefully enough. And I always like the sound of the wind through the trees. When the wind goes through the palm trees, it sounds like the ocean. Without having to sleep near the ocean. I don't know what it is, but... And I know maybe I'm like the only person on planet Earth, maybe. But sleeping by the ocean and listening to the ocean all night, I can't help but think about what's in there. Like, yeah. Do I feel scared? No. But I feel something spiritually calling me into the ocean that feels very overwhelming for me. I know that sounds super weird, but it's just the damn, it's just the truth. Talking about, oh yeah, I want to talk about how my friend's beauty inspired me even to this day. And I'm not friends with this person anymore. You know, some of these connections, they just came down to like social media connections. And this is a person who would like, you know, watch my stories constantly and like never respond to anything, never say happy birthday, never like I'm sorry for your loss, like nothing, just sit there watch. So finally I was like, I'm gonna cut this person off, and I do that, you know, quite frequently. Yeah, and I think if people want to play a part in my life, you know, well, it's very easy to just stalk me from afar, like I'm sure someone is doing right now listening to this. But it's a privilege to have closer access to me. It's not something that I just give out for free anymore. You know, my friends list on Facebook is extremely small. I have a bunch of followers. Those are people who try to add me. There are like, it's a new thing. Or even people from the past who just want to know how to make money online. Okay, here I am rambling. Let me get to the story. So, I think of this friend of mine. For some reason, whenever I go to the gym, and I look at myself in the mirror, because we have this mirror at the gym, and it just like, I don't know, like, I wanna, I keep, you know what, sometimes I just don't give myself credit. Like, I tell myself, oh, it's a special mirror, but I guarantee you it's not. And I just look, I look good, I look nice, my legs look really long, and I'm wearing these Lululemon pants. And so this is a girl I used to work with, and I, at one point she was the manager of me, at another point I was the manager of her, and we both worked in the beauty department, and it was like a part of our rules for our dress code. We had all of these strict dress codes for the company that I worked for, which was Clinique. We had to wear like dress pants, no Lululemon black pants, even though they look super cute, of course, right? They don't look professional. So we were not allowed to wear those. And she would always wear it anyway. You know, I was the, you know, I'm not a following the rules person about some things, but I can be a following the rules person about certain things that are important to me, like maintaining standards. And, yeah, so the dress code was a standard for me. And, yeah, we had other standards too. Like, we had to have a full face of makeup. We were not to wear our hair down. Like, our hair had to be neat looking, like, pulled back or put up. We had to wear no long dangly earrings. We had to have neat nails. rules they have for the women in the royal family. And you know, it's not bad. Like, it taught me how to have a classy, beautiful, feminine, natural style. And I still have that to this day. Oh gosh, I could fishtail into so many different other ideas off of this, because lately I've been wondering about the hot look. I'm gonna get into that in another video. Anyway, so my friend, I ended up living with her at one point when I was really low. This was after my mom died. I completely forgot about this. How long did I live with her? Oh my god. I feel, you know, it's really hard for me to keep track of timelines in my life. Just because of all the damn drama. But, oh yes, 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 yes. Okay. So, yeah, I lived with her for, like, I would say 9 months. I lived with her during the time that I worked at Holt Renfrew. That was a crazy time in my life. I was just breaking down after my mom died. And it's like, it's obviously not because I was just so devastated. We had such a close bond, blah, blah, blah. No. When you have an abusive parent who dies, all of the things that you couldn't feel when you were a child because you were afraid of them can come to the surface. So there were so many things I was not allowed to be around my mother, and when she died, it was like everything just like fell out, like, you know, the lock on a door popping open that you'd stuffed a bunch of stuff in for many years and just finally bursting open out of nowhere. I was going crazy, and I had physical symptoms, and I was dating the clown, the absolute ass clown that got me started on researching relationships for the first time, when the light bulb finally went on in my head about what quote-unquote love was to people who are not connected to source, who haven't done any kind of work on themselves, who haven't resolved their childhood trauma, love, trauma bonds, love and sex addiction, fantasy, escape fantasies, dopamine, painkiller. That's what love and romance is. I came on here to talk about my friend's beauty. Anyway, we were kind of cute. You know, she had this one little extra room and she had an extra bathroom, and I could pay a lower amount and live there. And it worked out for a while. It really did. We had enough space. We kept the place clean. We didn't see each other that much. We both worked pretty often. But something about her beauty inspired me. Sometimes she'd be insecure about her weight. This is specifically what I remember. And she was a little bit taller than me. I think this girl was actually 6 feet tall. I feel like I've shrunk over the years. I swear I used to be 5'10 and a half. And now I'm 5'9 and a half. But she was 6 feet tall, and it was nice to have a tall girlfriend. And I remember she did gain weight. Like, you know, we used to go out and eat at, you know, Earl's, or was it Joey's? We would eat appetizers late at night. And she used to make all these, like, recipes off of Pinterest, you know, all those, like, really unhealthy ass recipes off Pinterest. She used to make those. And what about me? I don't remember what I did, but I have no doubt I had unhealthy ass eating habits too, so. Yeah, and I remember she did gain weight. I remember her telling me, like, oh my god, I gained weight, like, I look terrible, or I feel so bad. And she was, like, showing me, and it was this moment where it was, like, I could see that, yeah, she had gained weight. Like, I could see it in her, like, stomach. But, and I know this sounds so, like, wholesome, I thought she still looked really beautiful. You know, she still had her long legs, and she still looked lean and know, she always did her hair nice and her nails and her makeup, and I always appreciated that about her. And I'm that kind of girl too. When I worked in forestry, the guys used to joke that if I was on a forest fire, I'd be using the ashes for eyeliner. Of course, that's not true. Although it would cross my mind, and then I'd probably try to sell it. But yeah, the eating is distracting me. Just a moment. Yeah, so now I am able to turn that wholesomeness, that eye for beauty, that forgiving, seeing the best in someone version of me on myself. And yeah, when I look in the mirror, I see my long legs in my Lululemon pants, just like hers were. And I work out at the gym in a full ass face of makeup, still get no breakouts because I wear good quality makeup. I take care of my skin. And I love being that glamour girl. I really do. And when I do it, I think of my friend Steph, my old friend. And you know, we had one moment that I remember with her when I lived with her, where I really surprised her. I had met this guy. He was super attractive. I can't remember what country he was from. It might have been a Mediterranean country. I can't remember, but he had like that year-round tan, really, really beautiful, thick, curly hair. I think he might have green eyes, a great body, whatever. She had been out with me when I met him, and he and I had started talking. He had invited me out, and I said, okay, cool, he's gonna come pick me up at her house. So her and I were waiting and we were talking, whatever. And the time started ticking by, and then he was late. And then I was like, and we had confirmed earlier in the day too, so I was like, should I wait? Like, I don't know. So 15 minutes, 20 minutes goes by, and I'm like, all right, girl. I don't remember if I called him or texted him and got no answer or something. So I'm like, all right, whatever, right? And then he ended up sending me a text message, and he was like, oh, sorry, I'm running late. I was just visiting with a friend, but she's going to bring me back home so then I can pick you up, or like something like that. And like some kind of winky face or something. And he was like, oh, don't worry, I'm okay, I'm not hurt. Plus, she's a nurse. And they put like a winky face or something. And I remember looking at it like, what in the nonsense is this? You know? It was like he was trying to make me jealous. It was very obvious. And I didn't even know this dude. You know, I was giving him a chance to get to know me, and this is how he was behaving and expecting me to like whatever. And so I wrote him back, and I'm like, oh, don't worry about it. I get, like, I said something super classy back. I was like, no, don't worry about it. I'm actually just gonna go out with my friends instead, so have a nice night. And so, yeah, me and Steph, we went to go to, I keep saying Earl's, I can't remember where it was, like Joey's or Earl's. We went out instead. And then he texted me again. He's like, oh no, like, I don't know, like 20 minutes later, are you mad? Like, you know, like, I'm sorry I did that. I can still come, blah, blah, blah. And then I reply back, like, he's like, let me make it up to you. And I reply back, like, no, like, I don't know you that well. And, you know, I don't like guys who play games. I don't even have, you know, I don't even keep people as friends, like, who behave that way. So it's nothing personal, but it's not gonna work for me. So that's enough. Or I said, like, this is the end for me, but thanks anyway. Good luck in life. And Steph, when she saw that, she was like, what? She was like, you're not giving him another chance. I'm like, no, girl. He just showed who he was. You know, I'm not gonna drag this out and play these games. that about all people, especially men. You know, I give them a hard time and see what happens, and I watch them closely, but I'm not playing. And I remember she stopped, and she's like, oh, wow, like, I really respect you, or she said something like that, like, she was shocked that, you know, a guy this attractive who was interested in me, I think he was really successful or something, too, and I'd be like, nope, I'm good, take care. And the funny thing was, he also responded back after a while. He's like, you know what, I messed up, but you're right, and, I'll remember this going forward. I really appreciate you, and I'm sorry I missed my shop. Good luck to you too, or something. And I was like, whoa. I was really surprised by that too. And I was really impressed. So yeah, that's another story I remember about Steph. And yeah, she had been going through some things. She was dealing with a guy who was just absolute abusive, crazy, insane dude. And I kept trying to get her to leave him, and she would, and then she'd go back, and then she would, and she'd go back, so, yeah. Anyway, that's the story. Big, long, long story. I really appreciated her at that point in my life, and every time I try to get down on myself,